Hello guys, my name is Rohit Kumar Thakur, and in this video I am going to show you how to work with Firebase Cloud Messaging and React Native Expo. Here we are working with the push notification feature. The Firebase push notification works well in the foreground and background or quit state of the application. You can see the demo here on the screen as well. Now let's start making this application. For this, first you have to start an Expo application, select the blank template, name the application, and continue to dependencies downloading. Navigate to the project directory. Install the React Native Firebase app package first, then install the messaging module. Here in the official documentation, the code is well written with proper documentation. We just have to copy and paste the code into our application with slight changes. So please be careful and pay close attention. This module provides a request permission method which triggers a native permission dialog requesting the user's permission. However, on Android, you don't have to request user permission. Next, I am going to use the use effect hook. Using this, we're gonna tell React to remember the component changes. First, we're gonna return the FCM token key for the device. Just console log the token key because we are going to use this token key later in the Firebase Cloud Messaging application. When a user interacts with your notification by pressing on it, the default behavior is to open the application. So we are using get initial notification when the application is opened from a quit state. Just remove the few lines of codes because we don't need that here. When the application is running but in the background, then we are going to use the on notification opened app component. Remove this navigation because here I don't want to navigate to any data type. Next, we are going to register the background handler. When the application is in the background or quit state, the onMessage handler will not be called when receiving messages. Instead, you need to set up a background callback handler by the setBackGroundMessageHandler method. Now to listen to messages in the foreground, use these lines of codes. Here we are sending an alert with data in JSON format. You can customize this with a nice UI. Now we are done with the code, let's set up our Firebase and React Native Expo application. First, let's create a Firebase account. Here we have to set up the Firebase account for Android devices. You can set it up for iOS devices too, but here I'm using an Android, so let's continue with it. But before we continue, we have to customize our Expo application for Android. Here I'm using the development build method to test our application. You can use the base React Native method too. First, you have to install the Expo dev client package. You must have an Expo account here, and if you don't have one, I suggest you create the account first, then verify your email address. Now in the terminal window, log in to your Expo account using EAS login. Select Android, copy this command and paste it into your terminal window. Press Y. Do not alter the Android package name, so hit Enter and continue. Press Y to generate a new key store. Now let this build complete. This may take some time, maybe 5 to 10 minutes. In the meantime, if the build process disrupts, then don't worry, rerun the previous command and rebuild the application. Because sometimes the build fails due to server issue or maybe due to some other issues. Now our build is complete, so let's proceed to the next step. select Android, copy and paste the Android package name from the JSON file. Now, for the SHA-1 credentials, run the command EAS credentials on the terminal window screen. Select Android, then Development, because our application is in development mode. But if your application is in production, then you must choose production instead. Select Key Store, then set up a new Key Store, then create a new build credentials. And after that, hit enter. Here we have two SHA-1 keys. We're gonna use both of them in our Firebase application. Don't download the Google service JSON file because we need to add one more SHA-1 key. Now download this Google service JSON file and place it into the project root directory. Next, inside the Android section of the JSON file, you have to specify the location of the Google service JSON file. Next, we have to rebuild our Expo application. So let's do that. Wait again for 5 to 10 minutes. Now, on your Android device, scan this QR code with a QR code scanner. You can use your phone's default camera QR code scanner or download any application from Google Play Store. Download and install this build. Next, we have to upload our secret server key to send the push notification. The cloud messaging API is disabled, so enable it first. Refresh the page, you can see the server key here. We have to upload this key to the Expo server. Use the command given in the documentation. And we are all set. Now run this Expo application. Scan this QR code with a QR code scanner and paste the URL link inside the downloaded build. Okay, here I missed the messaging package to import. That's why don't copy and paste the code blindly. Just like here, I missed one important package to import. Moving on, now refresh the application and here you go. You can see the application screen on the mobile device. Now let's test the push notification feature. Write the notification title and notification text. We console log the FCM registration token, so copy the token from the terminal window and paste it here. You can see the alert notification on the screen as the application is in the foreground state. In our code, we wrote the code for an alert and the data in JSON format. Now let's test this push notification for the background state. Here I removed the application from the recent task. Now let's test for the new push notification. You can see that we got our push notification. So that's it for this push notification tutorial using Firebase and React Native Expo. See you in the next React Native project video.